Can the bass help you figure out the clave direction of a salsa song? Well, in this video, we'll find out. But first, welcome to Salsa Goals, where we break down salsa music and dance concepts so that you can build up a strong foundation on the dance floor. So if you have goals when it comes to salsa dancing, then you're in the right place. And be sure to subscribe for the latest videos. Now, in order to fully understand the clave rhythm as dancers, we need to understand how it affects the music. And in the last two videos, we learned how instrumental patterns like those of the timbales, the piano, and the congas can indicate the direction of the clave rhythm. But before we get to the question we've all been waiting for, how should the clave affect our dancing? What about the super important bass? Of all the instruments in a salsa music ensemble, the bass is one of the loudest. The pattern of the bass is called the bass tumbao, and some even feel that the energy of the band is in the bass. So should you use the bass in order to find the direction of the clave? Well, some theories say that you should, but let's see if that's really a good idea. For example, one theory says that the bass will always play a specific way depending on the clave direction of the song. The standard full bass tumbao is a three-note pattern, and some have said that if the clave direction is 3-2, then the bass tumbao will constantly play this type of pattern over and over again, thereby emphasizing beat 1 and beat 5 of each musical phrase like this. And if this is the case, the theory also claims that it's best to dance with on one timing, because the bass is emphasizing beat 1. On the other hand, if the clave direction is 2-3, then for each bar of music, the bass tumbao will always play a 2-note pattern that emphasizes beat 4 and beat 8 of each musical phrase. And that might sound like this. And if this is the case, some say that it's best to dance with on 2 timing, specifically power 2 or classic mambo timing, because the energy of the bass pattern supposedly fits better with that timing. But is any of this really true? Well, this theory isn't necessarily always wrong, it's just not always right. So, this theory is claiming two things. First, that the bass tumbao always indicates the clave direction of a song. And second, that it should also determine which timing you dance with. So first, does the bass always indicate the clave direction like this? Well, perhaps this may have been the proper way to play the bass tumbao in the past, but many of today's salsa songs don't necessarily follow that rule. In fact, in many cases, the bass will often play the previously mentioned 2-note pattern for each measure of music. This is because the bass tumbao in many modern salsa songs is often clave independent. Clave independent. What does that mean? Well, remember that a musical phrase consists of 2 bars of music, and each of those bars has 4 beats. This is a total of 8 beats of music. But even though the full clave rhythm takes 2 bars of music to complete, musicians usually count 1 bar of music at a time. This means that the bass player can often play a 1-bar tumbao pattern. In other words, the pattern repeats itself every 4 beats. These type of 1-bar patterns don't have to highlight the clave because they don't conflict with it. However, if the bass plays a tumbao pattern that lasts for 2 bars of music, then that pattern usually does outline the clave rhythm in some way. So here's the bottom line. The bass tumbao varies its pattern often and isn't very consistent, because some of those variations may highlight the clave in some way, while others may not highlight the clave at all. So, of the various ways that you can use to figure out the clave direction of a song, the bass might not be the best or the quickest way. In fact, other instruments like the timbales, the piano, and the congas might be a little more helpful and easier to figure out when it comes to the clave direction. And when you're out there on the dance floor, it's important that you can quickly figure out what's happening in the music. So, if you're interested in learning more about the bass tumbao pattern, and maybe even how to play it yourself, then check out the link in the video description below. And if you are enjoying the information in this video so far, please feel free to hit the like button and comment below. Now, what about the second part of that theory, which claims that the energy of the bass should dictate the timing that you dance with? Well, many of us use the rhythm of the conga tumbao as a guide for on-two timing, and this makes sense. Why? Because the standard conga tumbao rhythm is usually always in the background, which makes it relatively consistent and reliable. However, there may be times when the bass tumbao is so active and so strong that it becomes difficult to hear the slap of the conga tumbao on beat number two. And if this is the case, then you may feel that on-one timing goes better with that specific song. However, that choice is entirely up to you. You can dance however you choose. It's all about how you connect with the music. But that finally brings us to the main question that we've been waiting for. Should the clave affect our dancing? Well, get ready for part 6 of this video series because it's about to get very interesting. And until then, stay safe, stay connected to the music, and keep dancing salsa.